So for the development of these small businesses in India, government has come out with various schemes of providing assistance for the welfare and development of these small business units. Now let us look into various ways in which the government is providing assistance to these small industries and small business units. Basically, the government has divided this assistance in two different ways. One is the institutional support and the other is the support through incentive scheme. Government has set up various institutions which are providing financial assistance, marketing assistance, or also called as the non-financial assistance to many of the small industries or the small business units in India. Let us look out for all those institutions which are providing the financial and non-financial assistance for the small industries in India. First of those is something called as NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. I repeat, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, short and sweetly called as NABARD, N-A-B-A-R-D. NABARD was set up in the year 1982 to promote integrated rural development. Integrated rural development means the overall development of the rural areas. Surely the name itself is suggesting it is the bank for agricultural and the rural development. Whatever other activities are happening in the rural areas apart from agriculture, this particular bank will provide assistance for them as well. So right from its inception in the year 1982, it has been adopting a multi-pronged, multi-purpose strategy for the promotion of rural business enterprises in the country. So not only the financial assistance, they also provide various kind of non-financial assistance also for the industrial sector, the small business units in the rural areas. As I said, apart from agriculture, it also supports, that is the NABARD also supports small industries, cottage and village industries and the rural artisans using credit and non-credit approaches. Credit means they provide something called as a financial assistance. Non-credit means they provide the technical assistance, marketing assistance for many of these small business units in the rural areas especially. This NABARD also offers counseling and consultancy services and organizes training and development programs for rural entrepreneurs. So the entrepreneurs will require so many skill sets. What are those skill sets required to become an entrepreneur? What are the different qualities of an entrepreneur? So to inbuilt all these features in the rural entrepreneurs, this NABARD also conducts the counseling and the consultancy services, and along with that they organize the training and development programs for many rural entrepreneurs in the rural areas. So this is how NABARD is trying to help the small business units in the rural areas especially. Next institution that we have is, apart from NABARD, is the Rural Small Business Development Center, short and sweetly called as RSBDC, the Rural Small Business and Development Center. It is the first of its kind set up by the World Association for Small and Medium Enterprises. And one great thing over here is it is sponsored by NABARD. So this is an association introduced by the World Association. For what? For the rural small business developments. So this is also again speaking about the same thing, the small business development, especially in the rural areas. So this RSBDC is also working like our NABARD. So this RSBDC works for the benefit of socially and economically disadvantaged individuals and groups. So there are so many community of people or an individual who doesn't get proper benefits in the society. So for them, this particular RSBDC, that is the Rural Small Business Development Corporation, gives them a lot of benefit, and they keep them motivated and make sure that most of them start their new business. And also this RSBDC aims at providing management and technical support to current and prospective micro and small entrepreneurs in the rural areas. So not only the financial assistance or all the other sorts of assistance, this also provides the managerial assistance, technical support for all the existing micro and small entrepreneurs, and also for the prospective, that is the future micro and small entrepreneurs in the rural areas. This is how the RSBDC function. The next kind of institution that we have formed by the government is the National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC. This NSIC, National Small Industries Corporation, was set up in the year 1955 with a view to promote, aid and foster the growth of small business units in the country. That is, already existing small business units should be properly aided by giving the financial assistance, technical and non-technical, and also the non-financial assistance, and also to foster the growth, means make new small businesses come into the market or into the industry, to promote the small business units development in India, in the rural areas. This particular NSIC was being started in the year 1955. This NSIC focuses on the commercial aspects of these functions. The first one is that they supply indigenous and imported machines on easy higher purchase terms. So the small business which are not able to acquire the plant and machinery or any other imported machines on an easy basis, this NSIC will support them by for the supply of this indigenous and the imported machines on a very easy higher purchase system. They also procure, supply and distribute indigenous and imported raw materials for small business units. Certain small business units in India requires imported raw materials, but those small business units cannot afford to import the raw materials from there. But this NSIC will extend support in procuring, supplying and distributing not only the indigenous and also the imported raw materials for these small business units in the rural areas. They also work on the export the products of small business units and also develop export worthiness of these small units. If there are any classy products or the outcomes in these small units, this NSIC will promote the exports of those products into various parts of the world, and also they will make the small business unit a export worthy unit. Along with these supports, this NSIC also provides the mentoring and advisory services for the small businesses. They say how you can produce your product, how to market your product, and they will help them with the technical marketing assistance and all. Along with that, they also serve as technology business incubators. Means they give motivation in the rural areas to start new businesses on the small businesses in the rural areas and thereby become entrepreneurs in the rural areas. So this is all about the NSIC and its contribution for the small business development in India. The next kind of institution that we have is the Small Industries Development Bank of India, popularly known as SIDBI, S-I-D-B-I, Small Industries Development Bank of India. This SIDBI was set up as an apex bank to provide direct or indirect financial assistance under different schemes to meet credit needs of small business organizations. So this was basically set up, this SIDBI, Small Industries Development Bank of India, was basically set up to provide various financial schemes on the credit basis to meet all the credit requirements of small business organizations in India. These people, that is the SIDBI, will help to coordinate the function of other institutions in similar activities. So not only that, these people also will coordinate, and with the other institutions they will work for the welfare of all the small businesses in India. They will provide the marketing assistance, technology assistance and various other assistance also. Apart from this SIDBI, the next kind of institution that we have is the National Commission for Enterprises in Unorganized Sector. I repeat, National Commission for Enterprises in the Unorganized Sector, short and sweetly called as NCEUS, National Commission for Enterprises in the Unorganized Sector. The NCEUS was constituted in the month of September in the year 2004 with certain objectives. The objectives are to recommend measures considered necessary for improving the productivity of small enterprises in the informal sector. There are many small businesses which are unorganized, which are not at all registered, or we can also say the in the informal sector. So this NCEUS works on measuring or getting the recommendations for the improvements of the productivity of the small business units, especially which are in the informal sector. They also work to generate more employment opportunities on a sustainable basis, particularly in the rural areas. So this NCEUS also works on generating more and more employment opportunities in the small business units, and also those opportunities should be sustainable enough, not only for a short period of time, and it should be there for a longer period of time. And this work, they actually do it in the rural areas. And they also work to enhance the competitiveness of the sector in an emerging global environment. When we were discussing about the problems of small business sectors, we have said that this sector fails to face the global competition, but this NCEUS supports the small business sectors to deal with the competitions of the emerging global environment. This is also one of the greatest support that they are able to extend for all the small industries or the small business units in India. The next kind of institution that is providing support for the growth of small industries or the small business units in India are the Rural and Women Entrepreneurship Development, RWED, Rural and Women Entrepreneurship Development Institution. The main objective of this institution is creating a business that encourages initiatives of rural and women entrepreneurs. So starting a small business which can involve the initiatives of the rural people and make the more and more women entrepreneurs to start business in. The next objective is enhancing the human and institutional capacities required to foster entrepreneurial dynamism and enhance productivity. This particular RWED institution also provides all other kind of assistance and trainings for all the human resource, wherein they can improve on their industrial capacities, which are very much required for the growth in the entrepreneurial era. And thereby they also enhance the productivity of all the existing entrepreneurs in the rural areas. The next objective, RWED also provides the training manuals for women entrepreneurs, and they provide a lot of training to them, and they always want to improve the number of women entrepreneurs in the rural areas, because they feel the development of women entrepreneurs will lead for the development of the entire small business sector in India. And also they work on rendering other advisory services for almost all the small businesses, and especially to the women entrepreneurs in the rural areas. So this is all about this RWED. Apart from these, there are also other institutions which are extending similar kind of support. One is the World Association for Small and Medium Enterprises, called as WASME, WASME, that is World Association for Small and Medium Enterprises. Here, that particular institutions, not only on the small sector, they also concentrate on the medium scale industries. The next kind of institution is the Scheme of Fund for Regeneration of Traditional Industries, SFURTI, that is Scheme of Fund for Regeneration of Traditional Industries. Traditional industries means the industries which were giving a lot of scope for employment opportunities. So these institutions will not support the technical growth, but they make the entrepreneurs recruit labors to do the production part. So that is also one of the other institution. The next kind of institution is the district industry centers. The district industry centers, short and sweetly called as DICs, arrange programs, and it was launched on the May 1st of 1978 with a view to providing an integrated administrative framework at the district level, which would look at the problems of industrialization in the district in a very competitive manner or in a very composite manner. So this district industrial centers, they were forming various programs, and they were actually trying to understand what are the problems faced by the development of industrialization in a particular district, and they were always trying to come out with proper solutions to overcome such problems in that particular district. In other words, we can say this district industry centers are the institutions at the district level which provides all the services and support facilities to the entrepreneurs for setting up small and village industries. So these DICs will help almost all the small entrepreneurs to start their small businesses in the rural areas. So these are the various institutions which are providing the assistance for the welfare and the growth of small businesses in India. One more government's scheme for the upliftment of the small industries are the incentive scheme. Let us look into few of the common incentives that are offered by the government. First thing, the major and the basic requirement, that is land. Every state government offers developed plots of area for setting up the industries in that particular state. The terms and conditions may vary from one state to other state. Some states don't charge rent for that initial years, while some of the other states allow payment in installments for that particular land which is provided to run your business. This is one of the most important incentive scheme from the government. The next scheme is about the power, that is electricity. Power is supplied at a concessional rate, say of almost up to 50% concession. Whereas in few of the other states, they exempt the small units from payment in the initial years. Maybe they can ask not to make the electricity bill payment for the first 3 years, 5 years, it depends on the state. So they have given a very huge discount in the payment of electricity, that is the power bills. The next kind of incentive is water. Water is also a basic necessity in most of the small industries. So water is supplied on a no profit, no loss basis, or with 50% concession or exemption from water charges for a period of 5 years, and it depends. Few of the governments are providing water at a no profit or a no loss basis, and few of the governments are providing 50% concession, and few of the governments are giving exemption from water charges in the initial period, say for example maybe up to 5 years. The next incentive benefit is that the sales tax. In all union territories, industries are exempted from sales tax, while some states extend exemption for 5 years period. So in few of the union territories what we have in India, the industries are exempted from paying their sales tax, but in few of the states they are exempted from the sales tax payment at least for a period of 5 years. That reduced burden is there for on the small business. Next, other kind of the local taxes called as octroi. So most states have abolished octroi on the small business. They say you need not pay any other local taxes to the state government. So they have said no need to pay octroi. This is also one more beautiful incentive benefit given for small businesses in India. The next incentive scheme is that the raw materials. Units located in backward areas or in the rural areas get preferential treatment in the matter of allotment of scarce raw materials like cement, iron and steel, etc. So by giving priority for certain small business units, especially in the rural areas or in the remote places, the government is giving an additional benefit to them to acquire all the raw materials for those small business units on a priority and a very easy basis. The next kind of incentive scheme is the finance subsidy. Government is providing subsidy of up to 10 to 15% which is given for building capital assets for the small businesses. They are also providing loans which are offered at a very concessional interest rates, and few of the banks are also providing collateral free loans for small businesses in India, wherein they need not pledge anything to get loans to run their small businesses. So this is how the financial incentives are being given for small businesses in India. Then comes the industrial estates. Some states encourage setting up of industrial estates in the backward areas, whereas it can give a lot of scope for the development of small industries which are set up in those backward areas. Whenever these industrial estates are being set up, obviously the infrastructural development will happen, electricity power will come. So this is how the rural development also will happen. A very fabulous scheme by the state governments. And also other incentives given is through called as tax holiday. Here the exemption from paying taxes for 5 or 10 years is given to industries established in backward and hilly and the tribal areas. So for few of the industries which are established in such areas, that is in the very backward areas or in the hilly regions or in the tribal areas, tax holiday, exemption from paying the taxes are being given. In few of the states it's up to 5 years and in few of the states it's up to 10 years. So these are the few of the incentive schemes from the government for the welfare of the small business units in India. So this is all about the small business sector in India.